Hey, what's up, guys? This is Neal Reyes, and I want to welcome you to today's episode of Champions Minute. You know, I live in Texas, and here in Texas, it's just getting summer. And if there's one thing everyone's doing, we're all checking the temperature. But how about in our spiritual walks? As believers, are we checking the temperature as often as we should? Well, we're going to talk about that today. Get ready. Today's topic that we're going to be discussing is called temperature gauge. Again, today's topic that we're discussing, I've titled temperature gauge. One of the things I talked about in our intro is that it's starting to get warm outside. You know, here in Texas, it's definitely within the summer now. And as it is, it's getting warm outside. And many people on a daily basis will check the temperature. In fact, sometimes they'll check the temperature throughout the day to see how hot it is. As we do that, though, are we being as diligent with checking the temperatures within our Christian walks? You know, as believers, it's easy to follow the Lord, but it's also easy to get distracted, and as we get distracted, to cool down a little bit from where we're supposed to be. You know, and that in the natural, the hotter it gets outside, the cooler we want it on the inside. But in the spiritual, within our Christian walks, the colder it gets on the outside, the hotter we want to be on the inside. What do I mean by that? Well, the colder this world gets, the colder they get for the Lord, the hotter we want to be on the inside, where that fire within us that burns for the Lord is on fire and it's radiating that heat off of us to where others want to know what it is we're experiencing. It captures their attention when they see a difference, when they look at you and they see you happy. It's different when they look at you and they see you content or excited or just overall enjoying life. And when they see that, they'll want to know what you're doing or what's on you. And as they discover that it's not so much what's on you, but what is in you or who's in you, praise God, they'll want to be able to know what that feels like. Today we want to talk about temperature gauge. And as we talk about temperature gauge, I want to talk with you about some basic steps that I believe as a believer we should be doing to check where we're at. So I want to talk with you today about what I believe are six basic steps you can do as a believer to go ahead and check your spiritual temperature or find your temperature gauge as a believer. These are things you should do not once a week or once a month or once a year, but these are things you should do on a daily basis. And I believe if you do these six things, yes, there's other things than just this, but if you will start with these six steps, I believe it will benefit you. Let's review the list. So first on my list that I have to perform your spiritual health check is, are you spending time in the Word daily? So are you spending time in God's Word daily? I know what I mean by that. You know, if we go back to studying the times of Moses, when him and the Hebrews came out of Egypt and God was taking them to the promised land. Well, they wandered in the desert for 40 years, but God provided for them. But one of the instructions they had is that they couldn't store up today's manna for tomorrow. They had to get fresh manna every day. Well, with our walks, it's much the same way. Yes, the Word has a cumulative effect within our lives, where the more you study it, the more it accumulates within your lives, but you need to get fresh daily Word in your system every day. So, are you spending time in God's Word daily? Doesn't matter whether if it's at the beginning of the day, the middle of the day in your lunch hour, whether if it's, you know, while you're waiting for the kids to get out of school and you're in line to pick them up at the drive-thru at the school, whether if it's before you go to bed, but you should block off some time of your day where on a consistent basis you're spending time in the Word. The next one I have for us is, are you listening to teachings regularly throughout the week? This is a real big one and has really added to a lot of my growth as a believer. You know, yeah, we all go to church, or let me rephrase that. We don't all go to church. We should all go to church on a regular basis. But your pastor only has interaction with you about once a week. In some cities, maybe you have it twice a week if you have a midweek service. But how are you getting fed? You need to make sure that you're getting fed throughout the week. In other words, you should be listening to messages throughout the week. When you get to church, you know, the fact is in our natural lives, we don't depend on eating just once a week to sustain us. We eat several times a day. So in our spiritual walks, you should also eat several times a day as well, whether that be spending time in the Word, listening to teachings, but we should be listening to teachings throughout the week on a regular basis. I will tell you that the more you begin to practice this, the more you'll find it's a daily practice for you that every day you listen to a teaching. But if right now that's a stretch for you, at least make sure you're getting fed more than once a week. It's not just about going to church, but it's about listening to teachings multiple times a week. The next one we have is, who are you fellowshipping with? This is a really big one. You are who you hang with. So who you're fellowshipping with will either add to your value in life or it will subtract from it. And what I mean by your value in life, I'm not talking about who you are as a person and your value in this world. What I mean is the value and quality of your life. If you're hanging with the right people, they're gonna challenge you to grow and come closer to the Lord. But if that's not who's in your life, if that doesn't describe who you're fellowshipping with, then it's time to do a health check and ask the Lord for some new friends. It doesn't mean to ignore those people, but it's time to increase your circle to where it brings you closer to the Lord and not further away from Him. And you should also be a balancing for them as well, because iron sharpens iron. You should also encourage and challenge them as much as they're challenging you. The next one that I have on my list is, what are you influencing your soul gates with? You know, everyone has three gates to their life. They have their eye gate, which is what they see. They have their ear gate, which is what they hear. And they have their mouth gate, which is what they speak. What are you influencing your soul gates with? What kind of music are you listening to? What kind of TV are you watching? You know, what are the things that you're saying or repeating that are coming out of your mouth? What images are you taking in? What thoughts are you taking in? You know, all three of those things, your eye gate, ear gate, mouth gate, will begin to influence your thoughts and will begin to sow seeds in your heart. And out of the abundance of a heart, a man will speak. And as a man is in his heart, so he will be. It's so important to guard those soul gates within your life. The next one that I have for us is, are you going to church weekly? Now, this is number 5 on my list. It's almost down at the very bottom. Why? Some people would want to put this at the top, but I put it towards the bottom. And the reason why I put it towards the bottom is because, yes, going to church is a good start, and it's something you should be doing on a weekly basis. And if you're saying, Brother Neal, I go more than once a week, fantastic, maintain that. It shouldn't be about a religious act, though. You know, religion is man's way of trying to become righteous before God's sight. We're not talking about religion. We're talking about personal relationship and growth with the Lord. So when you go to church, and that's number 5 on our list, you should be plugged into a good spirit-filled church where they're feeding you weekly. It's not just something you check off your list and say, okay, I went to church this week. This should be something that you're looking forward to all week to going to, because you know you're going to get fed. However, that feeding should be in addition to what you're getting throughout the week. Put it lower on the list, because I believe that that's a once a week thing, and there are things you need to be doing through the week on a daily basis that help build you up as you get to church. And the 6th one that I have on our list, and the last one, is, are you involved in serving the Lord at your church? What do I mean by that? Many people go to church, but are you involved in serving? A lot of times people think that when they're at their church and they serve, that they're serving the church. And yes, they're serving the church or that pastor who runs a church. And let me just throw this out there, because I feel impressed too. If you're serving at your church and your pastor has no idea who you are, don't think that that's not appreciated. You know, pastors meet a lot of people, and it's challenging for them to know everyone's name and their walk in life. Some pastors are better about that than others, just or some bosses are better about that than others. But just because they may not know who you are personally, just because they may walk by you and not shake your hand or something like that, don't be offended by that. Because when you're serving in that church, you're actually serving unto the Lord by honoring that pastor, by honoring that person. So don't be offended by that. In fact, what I will tell you is that as you are faithful in your serving, the more time you stay faithful in your serving, eventually that pastor most likely will know who you are, because they know who the people are that are usually contributing to their church. And keep in mind that the bigger the church, the more people they have to meet. So be graceful with them. They're taking a lot of time. You know, do you want them, and I know I'm going off on a little bit of a tangent here, but do you want them more focused on putting the message together that they're being led by the Lord to teach you each week? Or do you want them being more focused on being a social butterfly and getting to know everyone in the church? Right? I mean, really, you go there because you're depending on some spiritual food. So let them lead the way the Lord's called them to lead. Guys, I hope you enjoyed today's teaching as we talked about how to check your temperature gauge or how to do a spiritual health check within your life. As always, we want to remind you to go ahead and swing by our website. It's at neilreyes.com. You can find us there at all times. You can also find all of our teachings there 24 hours a day to stream at no charge to you. And if you need to reach out to us, you can also do so at our contact page, whether if it's a question or if there's something you'd like to be taught on. We'll take that before the Lord and pray about it. In addition to that, we also invite you to swing by our social media, which you can find right here. It's our social media. You can find us on our YouTube channel. You can find us on Facebook, or you can find us on Twitter. Guys, as always, we want to remind you that Jesus is the Lord and He loves you, and so do we. Thank you, and have a blessed day. Drop.